Why is my sheet metal flat pattern length incorrect? This is a common question I hear from SOLIDWORKS users. The answer, however, is surprisingly simple. Almost certainly, the calculation method you are using differs from the calculation method used by SOLIDWORKS. Although the answer is simple, that probably doesn't help solve the problem. So, let me elaborate. SOLIDWORKS uses one of three methods to calculate a developed length: bend allowance, bend deduction, or K-factor. When calculating the developed length manually, typically bend allowance or bend deduction are used. However, the default method for SOLIDWORKS is K-factor. This is often the root cause of any incorrect developed lengths. Also, the default K-factor value is 0.5, which is often unsuitable. A bend allowance calculation uses the sum of the straight lengths A and B, excluding the bend region, then adds the bend allowance value specified by the user. In a similar way to bend allowance, a bend deduction calculation uses the sum of the straight lengths A and B, this time including the bend region, then subtracts the bend deduction value. In K-factor calculations, we use the sum of the straight lengths A and B, excluding the bend region, then add on the arc length. The arc length is derived from a neutral axis positioned by a user-specified value. This is a unitless value between 0 and 1. 0 positions the arc on the internal surface of the bend, and 1 positions the arc on the external surface of the bend. K-factor is a user-friendly method of calculating a developed length. This is due to the fact a single user-defined value can cover all situations. However, in situations where accuracy is paramount, bend allowance or bend deduction tables are usually employed.